checks. So eye checking is one part of his examination.
It would not be as good as what Nutty or me can do.
Nutty ke paas jaake karta hu na main.
Baat 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 baat.
Wo to chalu hai.
Okay.
Following all basic rules, I am little.
We are live now. We are live now.
Okay. Be careful.
Just a minute, sir.
Sawdan. We are live. Okay, doctor, ready.
So we are live.
Yeah, ready. Shoot.
Good evening, friends, and welcome back again on this Thursday evening at 8:30. We have a wonderful speaker this evening. We are very happy to have him here this evening, and he's none other than D. Sivanandan, our police commissioner of Mumbai. He was promoted as the police commissioner after the aftermath of the 2008 November 26/11 attack in Bombay. He's one of the India's most well-known and highly regarded IPS officer. And I can tell you on a personal note, knowing him from the past 20 years, he had told me even before he became the police commissioner that when I am the commissioner, I promise you there will be no bomb blast. Now, this is not a small talk. He's a man of his words, punctual, elegant, smart. From the angle of his eyes, he can recognize people. He may not show that, but that's how great he is. His career spanned over a period of high profile posting over 35 years. And he is known for his use of strategy and intelligence to uphold the rule of law. He served as an active member of the Special Task Force of the National Security Council Secretariat. And he helped in restructuring India's internal and external national security provisions. D. Sivanandan was appointed as the Joint Commissioner Crime for Mumbai in the mid-1990s to tackle the growing gang wars in the city. During his tenure, the city witnessed, hold it, 238 encounters with gangsters. During his tenure, he was involved and making Bombay very safe by crushing a major part of the underworld. That is something I was very much a part of, to see how he tackled that so well. That for once, Bombayites, all kinds of business people, professionals who were under the threat, could live and eat and breathe freely in the city of Mumbai. Professional highlights, well, he retired as, of course, the Director General of Police, the highest ranking police officer post for an IPS in any country. And that retired in March 2011. He was Deputy Director with the Intelligence Bureau from 87 to 91. He was tasked with protecting the national against international criminal syndicates. So he has also been with the CBI, the Central Bureau of Investigation, between 2000 and 2004. And 6 years in the Mumbai Crime Branch as the Additional Commissioner of Police Crime and Joint Commissioner of Police Crime between 93-95 and 98-2001. And he really did justice to that job. During his years in Mumbai Crime Branch, he is credited with having broken the back of the underworld. And then he was in Nagpur as the police commissioner also. He has been the Deputy Inspector General for the Nagpur range, focused on the anti-Naxal operations between 95 to 98. And then he was the police commissioner of Thane for a long period, where he was very much responsible for making quite a few contributions to the police fraternity. He started the school for all the children of the policemen right over there. He also started a hospital. Now, this is something which I could be very proud of because I was there for the opening. And those children have done very well in their life and they have got to the meritorious boards also. And that was one work by D. Sivanandan. He was responsible for putting up a lot of gymnasiums across the city for the city police, for the fitness centers. He did multiple things under things to see that his boys were secured. They were happy. Their family was looked after. He was the recipient of the President's Distinguished Service Medal 2000, as well as the Meritorious Service Medal in 1993 for the internal security. He was co-authored one of the best books which I'm going to talk to him about. It was the national bestseller for a long time, the book on Chanakya, Seven Secrets of Leadership. So he was also a management man. He was an economics guy, management, IPS officer, a lot of things. His book was translated in 5 national languages and 80,000 copies being sold. But we are going to come to something very important little later in life. He is most important and very, very fruitful during Corona times. About 2 years back, he started his Roti Bank. I'm going to ask him a lot about his Roti Bank, which is a great service to this society. Sir, welcome. Good evening. If I speak more, I will not let you speak at all. And I cannot do that. Thank you very much for spending your time.
Everyone who is listening to his wonderful introduction, I feel very, very charged and motivated because Dr. Himanshu says all good things about me. But that's a secret between friends. You know? What are friends for if they don't speak well of each other? Okay. Thank you, Dr. Himanshu, for boosting my morale.
Thank you so much for being with us. And there is no question about it that Roti Bank has been a great thing and the school police. So, being on this present current scenarios, let me start with the bombshelling activity that has been going on television. Full day we have been bombarded. What is this going on? Our soap opera going on every news channel. So the Sushant Singh Rajput case, how do you think the police should have handled this case? Because after going from the suicide angle to the murder angle, and now it's gone to narcotics. So would you just explain for a common man like me to understand that what are we being taken for?
Doctor, the old school of policing would always say that any case under investigation should not be laid bare on the table for people. So only during this gang war, which you talked about, the press went to town by saying that before the shootout is over, they will come up to my room, Joint CP Crimes room, and say that which gang did it, what gun was fired, how many rounds were fired, which gang did, what is the name of the shooter. I used to tell them, you are asking questions as if I only did that and coming and sitting and talking to you. So that is because the TV channels had not grown to this level at the time. And TV channels have started coming to into existence that time. But then they didn't want to do very hard work. They didn't want to go there and do all this. Like, for example, today somebody is telling, oh, I have engaged 45 investigators to investigate Sushant Singh Rajput Singh. So I used to wonder, you know, are mera time pe aisa apne 45 investigators lagaya hota, main to kaam hi nahi kar raha tha. You could have prosecuted, you could have gone to the court, you could have hung that fellow, no? So today, this evolution of the TV channels into the persecutor, prosecutor, the judge and the hangman. Tomorrow, I'm wondering whether they will hang somebody, call somebody and saying that you are the one in my investigation I found. You had killed Sushant Singh Rajput. Here I am executing you. So please, I request all of you to wait for a day when these guys will get excited and call someone and hang him also in front of you. So what I'm trying to say is the old school of investigation always said, ladies and gentlemen, we are investigating the case and it is bound to change every day as per the availability of evidence. So we are not revealing all our cards. As and when we finish the investigation, we will come and lay it in front of you absolutely bare. You know, that is how it used to be. You have seen Priya Rajvansh case, you know, pretty actress of the elder years. So we investigated, we did a second postmortem, and then we prosecuted the people, Rekhan Ketan Anand, and it ended in life sentence. Nobody knew. None of your audience, whoever is listening to this, would ever know that case has happened. It was as sensational as this. She was also a very pretty actress, okay, little elderly, all right. But she had no backing of what all is happening. There was no Bihar election and there was no Nitish Kumar and things like that. So that happened quietly. No one mobbed me and asked me, what did you do? It was neither this nor that. Other high profile cases also I would like to mention. For example, Arushi Talwar. Or for that matter, the Sheena Bora murder. All these things, high profile, and nobody killed Jessica Lal. These are the type of examples I can give, where the media, for whatever purposes, CRP or whatever it is, they are doing the role of the police. But unfortunately, they do not have the accountability of going and presenting their case in front of a judge. Which we do. When we present a case as a charge sheet doctor, we have to prove it beyond a shadow of doubt. I request all your friends to note my words. When we present a case before a judge, whether it is a sessions court or later high court, then Supreme Court, we are supposed to prove a case beyond a shadow of doubt, between inverted commas. Even if somebody, an able lawyer, brings a shadow of doubt in the presentation of our case, you are getting acquitted. Now, we have a responsibility and we used to behave in a very, very responsible way. Now, what is happening is, I'm not saying they're irresponsible, not accountable and all that, but the number of cases getting convicted is coming down drastically. Okay? Because they are not keeping quiet and they are coming up with a lot of leaks. You know, this giving leaks is a new trend which I have not seen. We never leaked. We were absolutely intact, you know, the leaking, that holes were not there in our body politics or body system or whatever it is. But now these leaks are terrible, you know. There's no way to investigate. So I would like to say that the evolution of this information economy, the knowledge system which we have developed, has gone beyond anybody's belief. And so it is just information overflow. So in that bargain, I want to say one last sentence. The major issues which we are facing in the country, like the economy, the unemployment, the poverty, and various other things, no one has time to discuss that. Only one example I will give. When the Roti Bank was running before the coronavirus, as per statistics in India, there were 200 million Indians going hungry. But as on today, as per the admission of our Honorable Prime Minister, 800 million Indians are looking for free food now. That is, what is the percentage of growth of poverty?
400%.
This has to be discussed every day. But now we are finding whether Sushant Singh Rajput did X or Y. Okay, you asked me how the Mumbai police should have handled or I would have handled.
Yes.
Well, register a crime, whatever it is. I mean, there was and investigated under 174 CRPs, which is the right thing. Registering a case against anybody is injustice that way. But then they could have formed a special investigation team. Give it to the crime branch, supervise closely. And the third one is to organize a press briefing authentically by an additional commissioner or a joint commissioner every day. What has to be told has to be told. And then if that information flow had come, last but not the least is the transparency. Now, if you don't tell everything to people, they are going to investigate themselves. Now, you see in the TV, they have seen this height of the ceiling and the amount of the cloth which he used and what is his height and what is that height, everything. No forensic lab had to do because they have done all the jobs themselves, right? That is what was missing, doctor. Mumbai police should have been more transparent, and all the flooding of a variety of diabolic rumors which have gone in the WhatsApp university, you know, was something which they could have prevented by authentically briefing every day by a man of the rank of an additional commissioner or a joint commissioner. I hope I've given you a satisfactory answer.
Brilliant, sir. Brilliant. Actually, very true. Very important what you said. Very, very important for a common man to understand that the right source of information at the right place. And maybe as you said, possibly somebody wants to make a small leak and take that little 2 minutes fame. That's what the whole party was spoiled. You know, more as a teamwork that should be done and allotted job to the right person. So now that comes to the point of leakage. from the other side, with so many encounters and with so much of rule on the underworld, I'm sure you must have got so much leaks from those kind of people. So your network must have been extremely strong. I just wanted, was very inquisitive from a long time to know your network to break into that big backbone of the underworld.
If you are talking about that time of 98-2001,
yeah.
You know, the gangsterism in Mumbai started coming to fore from 1960s. That is Kareem Lala, then Varadarajan Mudaliar, and then Haji Mastan, and all the movie making, Diwar, Mukkar Ka Sikandar, and variety of movies you have grown up with when you were in school or college, when you were a buddy, Green Horn Doctor, you would have seen all that. Very handsome looking Amitabh Bachchan quoting Praveen Babi and others, you know. So that is the time, then 70s, 80s, 90s, Daud Ibrahim came, Chota Rajan came, then Abu Salem came, and so many. This is an evolutionary process. As we grew, the humanity grew, even gangsterism also grew on the patterns of USA or any other country. And the money grew, then firepower grew and all that. They also registered a lot of progress. So at that time, Doctor, you're talking about Kabari. Kabari is just basically people who are coming and giving you information for the love of the police or the other of the police. They hate each other, so people can come and give information against each other. And or for money, you know, greed, as we discussed earlier, for money, lust, power, various other things. And also they want to, a lot of good Samaritans who want to eliminate the gangsterism. Okay, they have seen something and they give you information. That's the kind of thing. But what earlier in the movies, if you remember, police was always shown as one who came at last. After the whole thing is over, they will come and blow that whistle with their blue half pants and then say, you know, police are gaya and all that. They used to make fun of the police. But what made us to be on top of the situation and this laughter of this criminal stopped, our movie maker stopped, because we had our upmanship by way of electronic intelligence gathering. So when you are talking to anybody worthwhile, for example, A, the criminal A, for example, D is speaking from a foreign country, Western Indian neighbor, to his people who are there working for him in India. If you had the scientific knowledge or technology to tap that telephone, you could have intelligence. So if they were shooting Mr. Top Star XYZ or the director or anybody, I can give you all the names. They are all known to you. We had advanced intelligence where they would exchange weapons, who would go wearing what kind of a shirt and what time they will come. This, they never could imagine that the police, they thought, you know, we are all Buddhus as usual. Pandu, as you would like to call me. So I was the top class Pandu there. And then we pretended to be Pandus and we tapped the phone from Cambodia, Malaysia, as well as Karachi, and any other international number could be tapped. That when it dawned on me that we could do that, we had absolute intelligence. And later, all the weapons in the world is available for purchase, correct? Okay, if they had one state-of-the-art weapon, I had triple time state-of-the-art of the weapon. We had our bulletproof jackets, our training. Who is a sharpshooter? A policeman has to be a sharpshooter. There can't be any fellow just taken from Pratapgarh or Azamgarh becomes a sharpshooter or what? So when it comes to matching skills, our guys were fantastic, well-trained. So that is the... you mentioned about encounter. I want to say this encounter is nothing but a meeting between a criminal and a policeman. Like I come to meet you for my eyesight, it's an encounter between you and me, right? Sparks come, so people fall in love, you know, girl and boy meeting in the park is an encounter. Love emerges. When the policeman and the gangster meet, bullets were fired, you know, sparks come there also. So, but I want to tell you that all the so-called encounters are mulaqate, you know, encounter is mulaqat, were absolutely legal. There was an encounter petition filed by a person called Abu Azmi in 1997, when Javed Fauda and Bandra was encountered by ACP Vasant Doble. But then a judge, a very respectable judge called Justice Aguiar, inquired and said 95 other encounters were also fake, false, murder. That is where the Mumbai police got frozen and the gangsters got an upper hand. And that is where they went and shot 101 businessmen in 1 year. Dr. Himanshu, every 3.5 days one businessman was shot. Either it is Gulshan Kumar or it is Sunil Katav or Taqiyuddin Wahid, they're all your neighbors. Taqiyuddin Wahid is behind the Carter Road thing, no? So that kind of people, or Om Prakash Kukreja, very well known builder, or Vallabh Thakkar, these are all well known names. When this happened, there was a shake up, there was a thing. Even for that matter, Rakesh Roshan was shot, he was not killed. But he was shot. So that gave a jolt to Bollywood. That is where the wake-up call came. And that is where the need for controlling them came. And then the strategies, Chanakya's seven secrets of leadership emerged. And various use of technology, strategy, Sun Tzu, Machiavelli, all that came into the play. And what happened is history. From 2002, Dr. Himanshu, even today, until today, that is how many years? 18 years. Except J-Day shootout, there is not a single shootout, either from the police or from the gangsters. Otherwise, every 3.5 days, you divide 101 by 365, you will get 3.5 as your answer. That's what was happening. That is how somebody stopped it. That is salute to the Mumbai police, the entire team building. You told me about the schools and hospitals and all that. Why it was done? To build up a fabulous team, to give them a feeling that whatever happens to you, I am there to look after you, your education, your health, your various things, I'll take care of you. You come, Pandu, come and work for me. That was the call. Okay.
Oh, wonderful. I am witness to that from 20 years, that you really built up team and each one looks up. Even now after 10 years, despite not being on any post, all the senior PIs in my area come and respect you. They always talk high about you. There's not a single person in the police force who has backbitted you on any ground. That's wonderful. I'm very proud of that. And that bulldozing all those criminals at that time was very brave, because I'm sure you must have faced a lot of criticism from the politicians, from the rest of the people, and a lot of people would have interfered. And brilliant. We are very proud of you for that. That we haven't had murders like that on daylight, because Gulshan Kumar's murder was right in front of my clinic and I was there. And I have heard of that. So true. Thanks so much for. So now a question.
Gulshan Kumar's case, doctor. I'm sorry to interrupt.
Yes, sir.
I want to disappoint you and your wonderful audience that I never had any political interference. My God, what a strange thing. Nobody interfered. Nobody made a phone call. Nobody called me for an audience. Why? Because the existence of all of them were in question. Okay. That is the secret. When these guys were pampered by all people, when their own existence, you know, so many Shiv Sainiks and BJP, for example, that Ramdas Naik on the Hill Road, you know, Bandra Hill Road near police station, he was shot dead right outside his house. One Kelkar, and so many Shiv Sainiks and others were shot dead. So when that happened, obviously, when I, Balika Bakra from Naxal area, Gadichipoli se leke aaye the utake, I was a very innocent fellow, as you know, Dr. Himanshu. I didn't know anything. So I was brought. When I was brought, they said the baby will splash the water the way the baby likes. Not a single phone call. I never met any of the powers that be. Would you believe that?
Yeah, I believe. I believe you. I know that.
My boss was a legendary police officer. He was the most honest man. He backed up. He used to go and meet them. Whatever happened, happened. But I was never disturbed by anybody. It's very disappointing to say that I never delivered the heroic punchline. What is it? Aap jo bol raha hai, be kanoon hai, main nahi karega, kuch bhi hone do, main nahi karega. Aisa bolne ke mujhe chance hi nahi mila. I was a small little lame kind of a guy. Doing your job, you know, you went home and slept and all that. This telephone call, dumki, then the transfer, kuch nahi hua. The guy, okay, you transfer me. I would have gone, but then who would have been shot dead? Number kaha list tha na, unke paas ek list tha.
They were next on the list. So that's why they wanted to be eliminating those guys without coming on the list.
These guys exceeded their limit, crossed the Lakshman Rekha, then somebody has to say, now is the time to tighten the process. That's what happened.
Yeah. I have always been impressed by your memory of numbers and names and even the streets where murders happened right now. I mean, I've seen that every small street of Bombay, you know where this happened and all the names of your staff, that and brilliant memory even till today. So congratulations for that, sir. The next, I was always wanting to ask you, sir, if I don't go to my clinic for a week or a month, it will gradually fizzle out. I have a question for you, sir. 20 years plus or whatever number of years from the bomb blast, now that's disappeared. How can he rule sitting from there? I am amazed that how can his tentacles, even if I don't go to a place which is in Nagpur or a farmhouse of mine, it will rot. How can sitting from there, unless there is support from here, things could have gone?
Doctor, it's a very simple thing. The so-called press, the media, the cinema and the TV channels and the book writers, authors and all those people keep his memory alive. They keep on writing unverifiable facts to make him a living legend. For example, in a very, very highly circulated newspaper, they will say, oh, he did plastic surgery. He can't be identified. He's sitting in Bora Bora Caves in Afghanistan. What the hell, you know, where is Bora Bora Caves? Are you going to go to Bora Bora Caves, look for a fellow who has changed this face? This guy, he doesn't have a passport. Anytime, for example, when the legendary meeting between President Musharraf and Shri L.K. Advani took place in Agra, Marriott Hotel, the first question he gave a googly was, give us back Daud Ibrahim, and he gave him a sheaf of papers. Everything was given, and that chap was zapped, you know. And he said, no, there is nobody like that in our place. So they deny even today, he is the most wanted drug lord by the United Nations. And Abata Badme, Osama bin Laden was picked up in the same way. Somebody can go and pick him up. But India can't do it for obviously a variety of reasons, you know, neighborly reasons and things like that. We can't escalate a war and things like that. We can't take 3 helicopters and go there and land and bring him. But he is there very much, but obviously not in his own name, his own passport. You know, all those arrangements have been done. He's been protected by the ISI, the military, and the Pakistani government, and the Pakistani system. There is a government, an alien enemy government is protecting him. So obviously he's living in a different name. There is nobody by this name there. Okay, this identity is not there. That's a question of, argument there. Give and take there, you know, that's about it. But how does he influence? I want to tell you, he is not influencing the way it used to be in 98, 99, 97. Where any phone call coming, people used to tremble and shiver. Go there, meet him in anywhere, give money and samjhata karke lete the. Abhi hai kahan extortion? If any doctor friend who is listening, ask him to raise his hand and tell me I'm getting an extortion call. There is nothing like that. And that's what the holiday which I talked to you, which we gave from 2002 to now, is a holiday because there is no extortion call. That period when you mentioned that height of 98 to 2001, where no marriage took place, you got a call when the marriage happened. You bought a car, a call came. You bought a flat, a call came. But now look at the towers, you know, I rise. Like, right from this window, I can see a 100-floor Lada building there in Lower Terrain. And the number of cars, every 3 cars out of 5, I can count a Mercedes or a BMW or any other high-end car. So there is iska dabdaba jo hai, aap bol rahe hain Daud Ibrahim ka, aisa kuch nahi hai. There is nothing like that. You tell me, where did you read in the newspaper about an extortion call to a builder or a hotelier or a doctor? You remember Dr. Deepak Shetty of Kalyan? When gangster demanded money, he didn't give, he got admitted. When he was examining, he was shot point blank. That is the only incident where a doctor, correct? You agree? You remember that?
Absolutely. I remember that.
We solved it for you. So yeah. This Yejo, if he is doing white collar business and if he is calling people and if some people are voluntarily giving him whatever chanda, as they call that in Mumbai, chai pani is another favorite word, or even what is that, golgappa ka kacha karke karenge. So that we can't go and worry about that. I hope you appreciate what I'm telling you.
Absolutely. I appreciate what you are saying. Very important message which you have given across, that he is more of a symbol in newspaper to keep his memories alive. He has lost a lot of his powers and it's not to be much worried about. That's a very important thing to a common man. Yes.
See, Gulshan Kumar took place in 1995. After that, what happened? Okay, Rakesh Roshan in 2000. After that, what happened to Bollywood? Nothing. How you are buying 2 grams of marijuana and NCB is calling you, there is no, I can't help that. No, that is not Daud Ibrahim calling them, okay?
So I'm going to ask you the question now that you mentioned NCB. So what is this role of NCB and what is the role of Bihar police in this present thing? Again, coming back to the current scenario.
You know, doctor, as on today, the ratings have come down. So this is not dominating the TV screen, particularly this death are hanging. That has been almost getting solved. But then this NCB is coming to the screen all the time because it's a smoke screen. They want to show all good-looking top-class actors so that you forget all your other worries, you know. that my hospital is closed, and my patients are not coming, my industry is closed, how do I pay the next month's salary? All that you forget and look at the A-graders. That's a variety of entertainment for people, keeping you occupied. Smoke screen, as they would say. But the point is, NCB is supposed to be dealing with the international drug rackets. And NCB is supposed to be doing top class, you know, things. Like, for example, the Golden Triangle, where from all these hundreds and thousands of kilos of drugs which is passing through Mumbai, going to Europe or to USA, those things have to be intercepted by them, and they are doing that. The local should put this foodie weedy, you know, like you are 2 grams and 53 grams of ganja, you know. The minimum possession is 20 kilos as far as ganja is concerned. So, you know, this bhang and this Shivratri, everyone drinks, all of you drink. So, the OB way here, the same thing only. Na? In a fashionable world, it's called marijuana. But ultimately, in the street language, it is bhang. So, this 20 kilos possession is the minimum one could do. But here, nothing has been recovered. Only what is recovered is a WhatsApp chat. If you had done in 2002 some WhatsApp with me on something like that, then you and me can be hauled that way. So I'm warning all of our listeners, better be careful as to what are you chatting on WhatsApp. You know, if anything like this, anybody can reconstruct it and then haul you over the coals. So one B.V. Kumar, he was the Director General of NCB a long time before, and also DRI, one of the legendary. He's given 2-3 interviews in the various channels in the last 5-6 days. He says there is nothing tenable. Even the arrest of all these small Sushant Singh's girlfriend and others, they say it will not stick to in the court of law when a charge sheet happens or when a trial comes. But then the mob wanted her arrest. So the mob is happy that she has been arrested. Evidence is what? That is a matter the agencies will worry later. Now the bloodlusty mob has been satisfied by the arrest of one Riya Chakravarti. So, these NCB and other things, very frankly, I'm speaking about the government agencies in which I was also part of it. But the point is, you have to do your job which is meant for you in a quiet way. Leaking WhatsApp channel, WhatsApp chats and all is no evidence. And these things have been taken from the groups which were indulging in all that. And that way, they are collecting evidence. But these things don't hold water in the court of law later.
Oh.
Beyond a shadow of doubt, the guilt has to be proved.
Wow. Okay.
And in this NCB drug cases, there are mandatory rules where you go to check. You allow your body to be checked by the people, and then you go and you can't plant any drugs there. You have to recover. And you have to recover a sizable quantity, which is mentioned in the law. Okay. If that is not there, it is all pure entertainment.
Oh, wow. That's very interesting. Very important information.
I hope they will prove it in the court of law later. But as on today, this evidence is there. As on today, I mean today, on 24th of September, whatever has come forth in the public is just not evidence.
Very, very important point that you mentioned, sir. But on a similar corollary to that, what happened during those times, sir, we were talking the other day and you said, a lot of small petty criminals will come on the fore because of the economic problem that we are going to be facing post-COVID. In the next 6 months, 1 year. So everybody should be watchful that they don't show off their phones and their cars and then don't keep anything in an open car. Am I right, sir? Would you like to talk a little on that?
That is, doctor, a seasonal forecast which the police always gives. For example, today, all of us are locked up in their houses, so the housebreaking cases cannot happen. But everybody is there in the house. So earlier when people locked their houses, husband and wife went away for work, they used to break the lock and come and deal with that. But today all of you are doing work from home, right? Everybody is glued to the monitoring panel, they're doing work from home. But as I mentioned earlier, the poverty index, the hunger index has gone up from 200 million to 800 million. That much of unemployment is there and that much of poverty has grown up. Tell me what else they will do. With the gold touching 50,000 rupees a tola or whatever it is, one chain snatching of 10 tolas or 5 tolas minimum South Indian lady would wear, he's going to look after them for a month or two or three. There have been lots of cases where the bags have been stolen, the wallets have been stolen, the gold chains have been taken away, the mobiles have been taken away. This warning I have been given right from the beginning of coronavirus. besides feeding all the people, I've been telling them, please ensure your valuables in the house and don't carry and flaunt your valuable things outside, because there is 800 million people who are going hungry. They have wives who are going hungry. They have children going hungry. If somebody is going to commit a crime for feeding their children, I would sympathize with him. I hope you understand it in the right
way. I understand. Absolutely. I remember my daughter was studying at Johns Hopkins, Baltimore. And the professor on day one, I was very scared to leave her there because there was the black area and notorious criminals. Yeah. Every block, there used to be a cop in a booth there in Baltimore. Yeah. So the professor said, don't worry, it's not that bad. Only thing, while coming to the hospital, don't show off your cell phone. Don't wear some expensive rings or something. Don't flash a flashy bulb around you. Don't do that. Then you are safe. Very, very important message that you've been given. That's true.
Okay, I'm sorry, butting in.
Yes.
Cyber crime is one place where lots of people are losing money now. So all the fancy people like doctors, engineers and educated people are all losing lots of money and they are unable to go to police station. The other day, Mr. Ajit Doval, NSA, has given a lecture on Police Foundation Day. He mentioned in his speech, anybody can Google search now as I am talking, he mentioned in his speech that 500% growth of cyber crimes is there in this country. So it's a very easy for people to go and rob you from your credit card, debit card, your various transactions and things like that. So beware of your mobile banking and all this kind of a thing. Keep safeguard, you know, safeguard and save your property, because today is a very, very, people are in need of money and food and various other things. The other one, doctor, is this internal impatience which is growing because of the lockdown inside the house. The husband and wife are locked down. They can't go and do anything outside and they can't even step out. So the domestic violence has gone up by a few thousand percents, no?
I wanted to ask you that only, that what do you think about domestic violence, which I hear gradually, you know, people, a lot of them don't complain, but it is a very scary thing. Please, please.
They can't go out to police station because you are telling 2 kilometers beyond, you can't go for non-essential things. So the policeman would ask, what is very necessary that your husband is beating up? You don't have to go to police station, which is 2 kilometers and beyond, you know. So it's funny. No one goes outside because they have to come back and live in the same house, same person. There's no choice where a woman or a man can go out and buy another, rent another house and live. So you are necessarily, you have to be patient with each other. Whereas people are suffering from impatience, anger management is a major course we can conduct for everybody. So that is another crime which is growing up due to corona.
Yes, sir. 500% increase in cyber crime, which means we should ideally not do too much on electronic transition and don't leave your footprints on any computer which is not yours. Am I right, sir?
You have to have a strong password, doctor. Yeah, computer today, it has become part of your children. You see, schools have become computers now. Earlier, we were telling children, don't look at the phone, eyesight will get worse. But this whole school is inside your computer, no? Or your mobile phone. So eyesight can go to hell, but the school has to happen in, this, in the mobile. So today, I would say that have a strong password, don't share it with others, and keep minimum balance in that account where your credit card and debit card functions. Have one more account where your savings can be there. I hope. And all your valuables be kept in the bank lockers. And what you keep in the house, keep it insured. I've given you enough. You can say in the police tone, I have given instructions. Actually, it is not instruction. It is information I have given.
Very, very important. I'll repeat exactly what you said, that very important for everybody not to keep in the same debit credit card any money except an X amount of, say, 50,000 or whatever that you might use maximal. Keep it in a savings account, which is maybe in a different account in the same bank or another bank. Very, very important point that you, I would like to conclude, and makes point, it makes life a lot more easier, because that is where the crimes can happen. If I have they've exceeded the limit, suddenly my account could be zero and I wouldn't know what is happening. So domestic violence to be taken care of, and how to take care of the valuables, and a strong password. Sir, I remember you were one of the first ones to start a cybercrime cell in Thana, and I am very much aware of you.
In Mumbai, 98-2001, I was Joint Commissioner of Police.
Yes.
I remember Mr. Bujbal coming and then inaugurating in a big way, because I realized that the future crimes are all going to be cyber. Yesterday, or day for yesterday, if somebody is getting Indian Express, kindly see. In West Germany, in Germany, they have done the first cyber murder. These guys hacked the hospital records entirely and the patient has to be shifted from that hospital to some other hospital, and because the entire system, computer system, got completely hacked, the patient was being shifted from this hospital and another, and he died. They described that as the first cyber murder in the world.
Wow.
Yesterday, day before yesterday, Indian Express, page number 9 or 10 or whatever it is, people can check, and Google check. Google check now and get back to me. I'm answerable to you.
Wow, amazing.
Germany, by hacking a hospital, they completely changed the record and brought it to a standstill.
Amazing. Sir, on the same note, during this corona time, property crime, sir, that has increased right now. The lessee and the landlord or whatever kind of deals. Would you like to share something more on the property crimes which have increased? And what precautions can be taken?
For example, there's robberies and housebreaking and pickpocketing and chain snatching. All these things are coming under the same property crime. Body crime is there, maramari, you know, assault between husband and wife or the neighbors or whoever is assaulting each other. These are all the body crimes. So I given you a warning that property crimes are bound to increase. By property crime, if you're asking about economic crime, white collar crime, do you mean by that?
Yes.
White collar crime, obviously, doctor. See, the regular good old crime, the old crime is that, the classic crime which we describe is where criminal and the victim come face to face, correct? Whereas economic offenses, cheating and various cyber crime and all, they don't have to come face to face, no. For example, online, I apply to you as a banker and ask for a loan, bank loan. I give all that collateral and all that. And then later I don't give. With the fraudulent motive, I do that. It could be about housing. It could be about job fraud, for defrauding, or variety of economic offenses. White collar crimes. Going up, doctor. We find that the banks are all going bankrupt. The NBFCs have gone bankrupt. And so many banks. What is the HDFC bank's share value today? Ask someone to check and tell you. It has dropped. It is dropped drastically, doctor. So are all the banks. I'm giving HDFC only as an example.
Yeah.
So are all other banks.
SBI, our main bank, State Bank of India.
Your NPA, your non-performing assets have gone up like multifold, doctor. It is part of the doldrum which we see in the economy. Banks and these financial frauds and white-collar crimes and all are going up like anything.
So next, being a doctor, now biggest thing which bothers a lot of doctors across the country, very, very important, is assaults against doctors and health workers. There is no limit. Nobody has kind of heeds to us. There is an incident. There is a small WhatsApp. Society as such, you know, since it doesn't bother their children, they kind of neglect it. Good learned people giving a lot of lectures here and there. They just put doctors on one side. Okay, hota hai. They really have not woken up that it could be their child. And these are the healthcare workers who are taken for a drive. They have been beaten mercilessly. Hospitals have been broken down. The Singhania Hospital, which was burned earlier on. You were there, you remember that. And whatever, would you like to share some light that what is it that we can do as doctors and as hospitals and healthcare workers to see that we don't get in? We are already faced with a dilemma where a patient has come to a doctor today in ICU when he's almost dead. The only person between Yamraj and that patient was that doctor.
Doctor, I want to start on a very positive note, because if I come directly to the truth and the answer, you will slap me sitting there. Okay, so I want to say that there were a lot of posters in between saying that why are the temples, churches and mosques have been closed by the government? Because all the gods have started wearing the white jacket and the stethoscope, and they are all working in the hospitals. So suddenly aircraft was flying up, showering flowers on you. Helicopters were flying, doing a flypast on you. And you, 1 minute, doctor, let me do my discourse. So you were brought up on a pedestal and you were worshipped as gods. Tirupati Devasthanam, you ran away from there because you wanted to be a doctor. So that is when the need is there, you become God to them. When I know, many of the doctors are my close friends, the patients coming for a surgery offer you so many things by day of nice talk that I'll give you a tower, I'll give you a 20,000 square feet place and all that. But the minute the surgery is done, he's asking for a concession. And if the surgery had gone wrong, if there is an eyesight thing, he says, I will prosecute you because there is negligence. And so much of defensive practice you are doing earlier than this corona period. And of course, when Mr. R.R. Patil was alive, if you remember, a lot of journalists were assaulted. And they, he was sensitive. He brought a non-bailable provision for that. When these doctors were assaulted in Hyderabad and all, they showed in the corona, they were being chased and all that. So then immediately non-bailable things were applied to the doctors also. A special act has been made. All those things have been made. But any amount of law and non-bailable sections are not going to protect you from people who are emotionally charged people. Okay. So that is what is happening. So this is a part of a wrong evolutionary practice, doctor. So when I come to you, I come with the folded hands. The minute you come out and say, I'm sorry, I'm not able to save your relative, I become a charged person. I look at you as different. And then you examine the bills. And you know, in WhatsApp, they're showing every day. Even today, I got a hospital where they say what number of gloves they charge, the number of visits they charge, all analytics come. But if the same patient is getting cured and going away, everything is hunky-dory. So this is just an evolutionary process of the patient. I would say that now I'll come to the bitter truth. The number of policemen died in operation, doctor, while doing operation, police operations, is 36,000 from 1947. 36,000. Doctors died in corona is something like 400. In Maharashtra alone, policemen died as on today in the morning newspaper is 234. 4,600 policemen are affected with positive cases. So my salute. In fact, when I wanted to start, I wanted to salute the health workers, all varieties of health workers, that they have done yeoman service. But unfortunately, today, this TV, the information and various other things have made people to become a Jekyll and Hyde, Dr. Jekyll and Hyde, over, you know, like that. The minute you have taken care of me, you are God on earth. The minute my relative dies, you become the villain of the piece. That is where the genesis of humankind is taking a different shape. So what I can suggest is the doctors have to be protected, they have to be taken security help, and they have to, you know, before breaking a bad news, they can always bring a able-bodied young person to protect you, and various kind of protective kind of things they can do. But whatever you do in good faith, you're protected by law. Negligence and all that. Okay, if you bring up the Mr. Prafulla Desai case, there was an IAS officer's wife died. He took it to Supreme Court for 25 to 30 years. You remember that case? It is an oncology case.
Yes, I remember very well. That was one of the famous cases. So, but my point is more important. You know, there are a lot of young doctors. A lady is called to a cop station. They are shivering. They have never seen and faced a cop. You know, I'm just telling you, I'm seriously worried that where a lot of doctors, if there is a...
You and say, cop station, you collect all the information and give it to me. I'll talk to all the cop stations. What you have to worry is not from protection from cops. See, when you complain tomorrow about anything, a cop is duty-bound to call the other party. Otherwise, you say, you're hand in glove with the other party. So, if some patient comes and says, you did negligence and my patient died, cops have to follow the procedure. You have an internal inquiry by your doctor's panel and they do all that. And they can do that. That's fine, doctor. What you should worry or what we should discuss is the rage, the anger management of the patients coming and assaulting. This is the whole hospital. Everything, glass is broken. The doctors are chased and assaulted. That is the more worrying thing. Any cop calling any doctor for having done duty, you take information, I will start a panel where we can go and intervene between the doctor and the, on behalf of the doctor, we can intervene with the cops. That's not a big deal. That's not a big deal, doctor. The problem, what you should discuss is the anger management of the patient.
Mob psychology, you know, when the mob comes and that's
lynching. The correct word is lynching, doctor.
What should the doctor do at that time when he's faced in that uncritical situation, you know, sorry state of affair?
When things go wrong and the patient is not going to survive, the doctors should have a clue, or when they go to announce that they have a clue, so they can take, have a one or two people to be the wall between them and the patient. When you break the bad news, see that you are not within the arm's reach and you can take this thing. Or you can take whatever preventive steps you can take. Because we don't know who is going to get angry and who is going to assault. You can't call for a police force before we break the news. A lot of people take it as my luck, no? If something happens, they say, okay, humara naseeb mein itna hi likha hai, bolke chale jaate hain. Very few people assault. But then, who is going to assault, who is not going to assault, you don't know. So I don't suggest you calling the police force. I was telling earlier that doctors can do a lot of image building. But then when they called you a devta and angel, uske aage image building kya karenge? Wo sab hua tha. You remember those flights flying over your head and they were showering you petals and all
that? That is like Smashan Vairagya. You know, over there, everybody remembers that what is the purpose of life and all that. Oh, that time they did all that. Nothing, I'm not saying at large, but you saw a recent last week's WhatsApp video where a patient was dead, a young patient was dead, and they forced the doctors with whatever. You know, this is what is bothersome to us. So if we could have a good meeting with your people that how can we get some kind of mental understanding how to face the situation, because it's very, very worrying to a lot of my colleagues. So thank you for sharing some more light. We will do that sometime with my medical association also with you.
You arrange a medical association. I'll come there. I'll bring the Joint CP Law and Order who is Vishwas Nandre Patil now, right? Yes. Very, very brave kind of fellow. He will give you nice talk and give you all assurance and all that. So I'll bring him. Or if this Commissioner of Police is not beleaguered as it is happening now, I'll bring the Commissioner of Police himself. That's not a big deal. Yes. But ultimately, when you are alone with an angry mob, it is not the police assurance which will come and protect you. You have to handle that in a tactical way. You have to have a hospital. Every hospital has got a security system now. So there are cameras, there are people. So you can get 2-3 security guards to come in between you and then you can announce the bad news. But then you have to tackle it with a lot of tact.
So I would say you should rehearse in your mind, God forbid a situation like that happens. What is your escape route? How to face that situation? How well to deal with it? If it is sudden, you will not be, you're not prepared. If you rehearsed it in your past, in your mind, it might be a little easier for you to bear because you're already shocked at the doctor. So believe me, no doctor likes losing a patient. No doctor wants a surgery to fail. Believe you me, and I'm very clear about that. So despite if something happens, what to do, and that is what they have to do. And now let's come to a very interesting thing. Sir, I want to hear your principles of Chanakya from your book. What is it that you are trying?
That book, doctor, is in 80,000 copies. When you are preparing my bare data, it has already crossed a lakh of copies and more. And a friend of mine, Dr. D.V. Kumar, my batchmate in Karnataka, is translating in the sixth Indian language called the Kannada. And in another 15 days, that will be released in Kannada language also. So it is doing very well. Since last 7 years, 27 prints have come. We have sold 100,000 copies, which is a good number to deal with. So what it is that it's a book written on me as a case study by Professor Dr. Radhakrishna Pillai. He has written 15 books on Chanakya Niti. Corporate Chanakya was the first book he wrote. The second book is this one, Chanakya 7 Secrets of Leadership. The book is on me, okay? As to how did this foolish fellow do the practice of Chanakya and succeeded in doing his job. So he talks about a slok, one slok of 6,000 pieces, which is written in Chanakya's book, Kautilya Arthashastra. One slok he has taken where it covers that the king, the minister, the treasury, the fort, the force, and the friends, you know, like this, there are 7 units which make a kingdom, how they work well. So this is what he described as to how this guy used all this thing and worked well and delivered results. So it's one chapter on Chanakya and one chapter on my working. And that is how MBA students and others find it as a good case study. And it is selling on its own. We never called Deepika Padukone for launching my book. I wish I had done that. But before that, the book is selling well. In the airport, when you go, all of you can see that there is a best-selling book with the Chanakya 7 Secrets is there. So it is working out well, doctor.
Yes, I know. It's your life. It's your life's work, which has been penned down and very important for a younger generation to see how you could also put Chanakya's words into practice in day-to-day life. It's not just great on paper, but how can it be practiced in real life?
Ultimately, yes. Doctor, it is Chanakya or Machiavelli or Sun Tzu or the Chinese premier. What is spoken about is the success. For example, this fellow, this Johnson, who runs, this Jamaican man, what's his name?
Boris Johnson.
No, the Jamaican, Elton Bolt, no? Bolt.
Usain Bolt. Usain Bolt.
Usain Bolt. Between him and the one who comes second, he's also incidentally a Jamaican. It's a one thousandth of a millisecond is the difference. But then this guy walks. He ran 115 seconds so far, and he has won 115 million. So for every second he ran, he has won $1 million. That's the price. Correct? No. But then look at the difference between him and the man who came second. It is 1,000th of a millisecond. So, but then he's got an edge. So what are we celebrating today as Chanakya and things like that? Those people who have been successful. So if you succeed, then everything is a hunky-dory thing. If you fail, you can see yourself behind the lockup also, no, doctor. The lot of police officers whom you know, I don't want to tell all the names, who are behind the bars. Correct, no?
Yes.
Gujarat fake encounters, Asurabuddin, and various things like that. Nusrat Jahan and so many things. There are lots of IPS officers who are behind the bars. Know that?
Yes, yes.
Tell all the names. You told me I remember the names and dates and time. But
yes.
I don't want to rattle all the figures.
Yes, yes. So now comes a very important thing. You're lovely. You know, I remember asking you that what is so close to your life? What is so close to your heart? And you said, policing is very close to my heart. But one more thing that I found in the last couple of years, because you've always given back to the society without any expectation, the Roti Bank, which has been a great aid to the society, and you've done a marvelous job with no strings attached, and you have got it organized so well. Would you like to talk to us and tell us what is this Roti Bank?
Doctor, for a long living, today all of us will be forced to live 85 years, you know. So I'll be getting pension for 25, 30 years without doing work. So now the question is, how do you find a life's goal? Like, what kind of a hobby? In Japanese language, it is called ikigai, you know. Ikigai means what is the reason for which you get up and run the whole day? What makes you tick like a gadiyal, you know? When you give chabi, it runs. So what is a chabi for you? Is it singing, dancing, painting, or having an extramarital affair? You know, even that can keep the doctors going. A lot of them do have that, no? I know a lot of cases where they have this extra ikigai, you know? So that's all right. But I found that policing in giving feeding poor. What is the whole policing all about? I told you policing is my breath. The breathing is police.
Yes.
If we feed the poor children and bring them to school and give them education, they will become employable and the future crimes can be reduced. I hope you see the link.
Absolutely. Absolutely brilliant.
All the shanties and all the slums like Dharavi, Mankud, Trombay, Cheetah Camp, Vikroli, that dump yard and all that, I go and feed the children with the most nutritious food, doctor. I don't give leftover food. I got a kitchen where I can produce 20,000 meals a day. And we see that the ingredients are good. When we give them, we see that physically they are growing well. Mentally, if you take a Mensa test, M-E-N-S-A, Mensa test, you can find how brilliant they are. And thus, they become employable. For example, the school you mentioned in Thane, it is 70,000 square feet. Policemen pay only 25%. And there are boys who are studying in Bits Pilani. You can Google search for a boy called Mihir Shinde. His father is a constable in the Bhiwandi police as on today. He's studying in Bits Pilani second year. So many are there. The other day when I go to Thane, some traffic policeman stopped me by force and made me to stop and told me, he put his head into my car and said, because of you, my daughter has become a chartered accountant and I want you to know about that. So like that, there are a lot of people who have done very well, doctor. So the streak of returning to the society as Ikigai, as part of Ikigai program, is there. I built a school in Gadchiroli and Chandrapur. They've grown very well. With a Naxal affected area. Then next one was Thane. Mumbai also, I tried, it happened because of the short time. But then the gymnasiums we made, we measured the physical head-to-toe medical examination of 50,000 people we have done. And all that we have done. So this is part of that. This is the extension, Roti Bank. 2018, January, we began 5 lakh meals in 1 year. 2019, I gave another 5 lakh meals. That means 1 million in 2 years. In 2020, my goal was to double it, go 4 times. That is 400% growth of 2 million. I would like to inform you, we have already crossed 3.3 million meals. That is, when you take corona as a risk, where I can get corona, my workers can get corona. Why should we do? We could have closed it, but we take a risk, whether it is an encounter or stopping crime in Mumbai or feeding the poor people when the migrant laborers were walking. That was a challenge. We take it up and we, on a given day, before this Ramzan started, the date is very well known, I think April 16th or so, we gave 37,000 hot meals, doctor. 37,000 hot meals in one day. Then it tapered down because of the Ramzan. But now we are giving about 8,000 to 10,000 meals a day cooked in my kitchen in Chembur. And we can hike it up anytime, you know. So that is the Roti Bank story. I request all your viewers to view, to go and see the rotibankindia.org. Mr. Amitabh Bachchan has given a fantastic testimony about the Roti Bank working that is there on the YouTube. People can visit. And what a graceful, you know, elegance with which he talks about Roti Bank. So that's an endorsement. So I request all of them to see. I don't want any money from any of your doctor friends who are listening to this, but they can just see how poor feeding would do control of future crime. Link this and that. That is what I want. Also, I will say Roti Bank is also part of policing, doctor. You are surprised to see that?
Yes, 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 yes.
It's also part of policing, because if the future crime I can stop by preventing it by feeding poor. Give them education.
Yes, 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 yes. Thank you very much, sir. I can keep on talking with you for a very long period of time, but with the constraint of time, I would take a promise today that I'll call you back again next time. Thank you so much for being with us and enlightening us on so many topics. This tough man who could also be into an encounter and download.
My watch, it is 21:29.
So yes.
Before you are closing your session, which is excellent. And I promise that I'll bring the police commissioner to assuage the feelings of all the doctors. I stand by my promise. I remember you organize a meeting. I'll bring either the commissioner or the joint CP law and order. Okay?
Yes. Thank you so much. But we are very, very thankful to you that this same tough guy with the underworld was scared shit when the name Sivanandan rang. They could only see Apta Chappan Ka Chhati. And here is a man who is so soft that he's feeding more than 3 million people with food, with his Roti Bank, with his Chanakya Nidhi. Absolute pleasure, delight and honor to be with you this evening, sir. Thank you so much for your valuable time.
And for all your friends, doctor, hello.
Yes, 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 yes.
I'd like to leave my mobile email, dsiva100@gmail.com.
Dsiva,
dsiva100@gmail.com. You can give, doctor.
Yes.
You can give, they can write to me. I can give them all the legal help they want.
Thank you so much. This is so reassuring. Believe me, it is reassuring to doctors because we don't know where to go. I remember the first time I had a problem and you had helped me, whatever it was. And that relationship goes back 22 years. And that was so reassuring to see your face. Don't worry, I'm there. And that's very important for all of us.
That's and what you said. Thank you to all your fellow doctors now, doctor. Me on dsiva100@gmail.com. Any emergency, they can take my mobile number from you and send a message or call. We stand, whether I retired or whether I'm working, I stand by my commitment. Doctors are real gods. I'm not the one who will assault a doctor because things went wrong. So we will stand by you and any help, anytime for anybody, we will do that, doctor. Thank you so much. Wonderful.
Thank you very much for being with us. Friends, thank you for being with us on this Mirror Wisdom Reflected. We had a wonderful talk this evening with none other than D. Sivanandan, a wonderful friend in the true sense, a man who lives up to his words, timings, every which way, a great human, tremendous thinker, huge personality, and what a memory. He can remember every small incident. Thanks for that. Friends, we have next week for some entertainment during these times, none other than Salim Merchant, whom we'll have some music reflected. No. Music is a window to our soul, and we will have next 1st of October, Thursday at 8:30 p.m. Salim Merchant to be with us and be there 8:30 sharp. Thank you once again for being with us, and most important, I would like to thank the backup team. Navneet, please come on the front. Thank you for being with us and organizing this so well and flawlessly.
So, sir, thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Navneet. Wonderful. You have done
thank
it.
Thank you. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Microvision for taking it further. And that is so, so important that we had a great time and unflinching support from everybody behind the scene also to see that the telecast goes well. Thank you, everybody, as a team, and Mr. Sivanandan.
Doctor, Yes. Dr. Pooja Mehta also. She also.
Yes.
Yes,
Pooja has also been very instrumental in coordinating with you and creating the whole thing behind the scenes. Thank you so much, sir. And I must tell that, friends, at this time, I remember one thing. As a police commissioner, when she was studying in New Bombay, you told her only one thing. If you have any problem, don't call your dad, call me, first thing. And that was so reassuring. And I mean every word of that. Thank you so very much. And Pooja is thanking you too.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Salute to your service to everyone. Thank you very much. Good day.
I enjoyed.
Good night, sir. Thank you.